Giving your body the nutrients it needs to be more fertile can be easy if you know how and what to do. In today's Fertility TV episode, I'm going to share with you the three things that you need to be doing to empower your fertility. Changing your diet and your nutrition can not always be easy or tasty. Sometimes the things we're going to talk about today could be a little bit meh. So I'm going to do my best to also give you some alternatives to make it easier and simple for you. My name is Dr. Marc Sklar, also known as the Fertility Expert. And welcome to Fertility TV, your YouTube channel dedicated to helping you get pregnant. I've been working with couples from all over the world through my online fertility programs and right here in San Diego at both of my clinics for over 18 years to support you all on your fertility journey. And this is why I continue to create these videos for all of you. And today we're gonna talk a little bit more about nutrition because it's such an important topic when we're talking about fertility and reproductive health. But before we do that, I do wanna let you all know that my online fertility coaching program, the Hope Fertility Coaching Program, is open for enrollment. If you want me and my team as your coaches to help you through your fertility journey and to help you customize a plan that's designed specifically for what you need, then I want to invite you to apply. You can use the link in the description below to apply to qualify. So now let's get into the details when it comes to nutrition. Now, I know many of you are already thinking, well, Marc has already spoken about nutrition and diet so many times. How is this video going to be different than what he's discussed in the past? I mean, I always talk about increasing your fat, having a balanced diet, eating organic, eating healthy foods, right? So I'm not going to do that today, although that's right, that is what you should be doing. And if you want more information on those basic foundational tips, then you can check out some of my previous videos, which I'll link here and in the description below. But today I want to get in a little bit deeper and I want to talk about some different things when it comes to your nutrition to hopefully round things out a little bit more for all of you and give you a different perspective and maybe hopefully allow you to start to incorporate some different things into your diet and nutrition than what you've already been doing. Okay, so tip number one. I want all of you to incorporate bone broth into your diet daily. That's 1 cup of bone broth at least per day. And this is why. You've heard me talk for so many weeks and endlessly here and there in many of my other videos about how important your gut health is to your overall health and especially your hormone balance and fertility. Well, bone broth does so many wonderful things, but one of the key things that it does is it helps to heal the gut lining, the intestinal lining, and helps to reduce inflammation in the lining. There's lots of issues that occur because of digestive issues and improper gut health, and one of those things is leaky gut, where the lining is permeable, right? It's called intestinal permeability, where the lining is not as strong as it should be. Well, one of the wonderful things about bone broth is it helps to heal that lining over time. It's not like a magic bullet, but incorporating that into your diet on a daily basis will help to start to heal the lining. It also helps to reduce the inflammation that's going on in the body, but in this case, in the intestinal tract. And if any of you have ever heard the saying that if you're sick, eat chicken soup, or chicken soup or chicken noodle soup is Jewish penicillin because it helps to heal us when we're not feeling well and make us feel better. That is absolutely true, but it's not from a can. It's from real bone broth. It's because traditionally chicken soup was designed and made by taking the whole chicken and putting it into the pot and letting it cook for a long period of time and then adding in the other things. And it's those nutrients that are seeping out of the chicken in this case, because we're talking about chicken soup, that are have the healing properties. Now, you can do the same thing with other animal broths as well. They can be beneficial in the same way. Beef broth, beef bone broth is very similar in that light. So it's really becomes a matter of taste, like what do you prefer when you're making it? I do love for all of us to make it because it is relatively straightforward and easy to do, and I like for all of you to know where your food is coming from. Now, the one thing that does have to be specified when we're talking about bone broth is that if you're going to make it on your own, then it is important that the quality of the poultry or the meat that you're using is good is that it's organic and grass-fed or pasture-raised, because that is an important piece to allowing your body to heal and allowing the benefits of the bone broth to reduce inflammation and start the healing process, and again, to boost your immune system. If you're having digestive issues, constipation, diarrhea, IBS, bloating, indigestion, anything like that, we need to take care of your digestive system first and foremost. And one of the first steps, not the only step, but one of the first steps to doing that is going to be bone broth, because again, it's healing to the digestive tract. And you all have heard me say that when our digestive tract is not functioning properly, the likelihood of having a hormonal imbalance, because we can't metabolize and excrete our hormones properly through the digestive tract, becomes higher. And so we do want to make sure we address that first and foremost. That is, by the way, for all of you, one of the first things I do with anybody I work with is go back to the root. And if the root is the gut, we start there always. One of the other wonderful benefits of bone broth is it's packed full of amino acids, and amino acids are really important for the detoxification process for our body and to maintain proper hormone balance. A strong selection of amino acids on hand for your body produces the optimal environment for your fertility as well. Other benefit of bone broth that we often hear a lot about is the higher amounts of collagen that's found in bone broth. Well, the collagen that's found in bone broth helps tissue repair and cellular repair, and it actually helps to keep our body young and youthful. It's one of those anti-aging nutrients that we really love to incorporate. And so as we're dealing with fertility and always wanting to support our cellular health and keep ourselves as young as possible, collagen will help to support and promote that as well. Collagen is like your hormone's little helper. When you have more of it in the body to be used, then your hormones don't have to work as hard, right? They get more support. So as I mentioned before, one of my favorite things for all of you to do when you're using bone broth is to cook it yourself. Put it in a slow cooker, put it in a pot, put it on low. Let it simmer for quite some time, minimum 8 hours, but it could easily go up to 24 when you're cooking it, which is why the slow cooker is really good and helpful. But we can't always make bone broth, at least I should speak for myself. I can't always make it. I don't always have the time. And sometimes when it's hot in the summer months, bone broth is really ideal to be drank warm. And I don't always want something so warm and hot throughout the day. So I do balance it out. I cook my bone broth and I like to sip it and drink it or make a soup out of it. But the other thing that I do is I like the powdered form of bone broth. And Paleo Valley makes a wonderful grass-fed, 100% grass-fed bone broth protein powder that you can add into your smoothies. This is exactly what I use in my smoothies as well, which makes it easier because it adds that protein. I'm confident in the protein source, and it helps to balance out my smoothie, especially on a warm summer day, to give me something cool and refreshing. If you want to check out the Paleo Valley bone broth and learn more about it, then you can use the link in the description below. Tip number two might sound simple and straightforward, but I promise you it's not. And so I'm just gonna say it first and foremost. Tip number two is increasing and eating more organic vegetables. That's right, increasing your organic vegetables. Now you might say, Marc, you've discussed this before. Why are you discussing it again? Well, I'm telling you that most of you are not having enough vegetables, and most of you are not having organic vegetables. So there's two points here. I review everyone I work with, I review their diet. Okay, I have you all do a diet journal that I review in detail and look through. And I'm here to tell you that even though I've talked about this topic over and over and over again, when I review diet journals, the number one thing that I see is that is typically missing is not enough vegetables. We think we're eating enough vegetables, but the reality is we're not. We don't incorporate it at every meal, and we're not eating enough of them. Now, for me, this is hands down one of the most important things that you can be doing. But aside from eating vegetables, they have to be organic. We want to make sure that the quality of the food that we're eating is top notch. And if you remember the video that I made last week, I talked about environmental toxins and all the pesticides and junk that we are surrounded by, especially in our food. And that is exactly why we need to make sure that the vegetables we're eating are organic, because if they're not, then we're ingesting all those chemical toxins into our body, and that's making it so much harder for our body to function properly and in this case, our fertility to function properly. So we want to support it and not put up any roadblocks as much as possible. And that's why having organic vegetables is tip number two. So I'm here to tell you that the first thing I want you to do is make sure that you put in an effort to eat more vegetables, eat more green leafy vegetables specifically. But I'm also here to tell you that the reality is we're all not gonna be perfect about it every day. And it takes a lot of practice and effort, and we're still not perfect. I'm not always perfect with it, right? But I do wanna stress that that's what we're striving for. We're striving to increase our vegetable intake on a daily basis and throughout all of our meals. But I also wanna make it more practical and easier for all of you so that you can be successful doing it and not have to stress about it. And that's where using an organic dehydrated vegetable powder is gonna come in handy. Now you don't have to use it every day, okay? Although this is the one that I use again from Paleo Valley because I trust the quality that you're getting from there. This is their organic super green powder. You don't have to use it every day unless you want to. You certainly can, but you can use this at the end of the day as a hedge, right? And what I mean by that is you can go through your day hoping and working to increase and incorporate vegetables into your diet. But let's just say you get to dinner time and you realize, hey, I didn't do a great job today. Then that's when you can open up this packet, take out a scoop, put it into some water, mix it up, and drink it down. And then you know that you've gotten your 8 servings of fruits and vegetables in your day in because that's what a scoop is of this beautiful powder. Now, the biggest drawback I hear from everybody is the taste, but I'm here to tell you this tastes excellent. If my kids will drink it, if my wife will drink it, then I know it tastes great. And so that's why this is also the one that I recommend for all of you. Another beautiful thing about this is, again, it's organic and it doesn't have any cereal grasses in this, which are hard to digest like rye and oats and wheatgrass. Now they might be good for you in some ways, but they are difficult on our body to digest. This is really focused on vegetables and super greens, and that's what they've incorporated. And you get to see that next to each one, it says organic, which is tells me that everything is sourced properly the way it should be, and that you're getting the best quality and the best nutrients you should every time you use that powder. If you wanna check out that powder as well and see what it offers and see if it's something that you wanna incorporate, then I'm gonna provide the link in the description below for you to check out. Okay, so tip number three is gonna continue down the theme of superfoods. Right? And we've talked about, I consider bone broth as a superfood, so we've talked about one superfood. We've talked about our vegetables, and that for sure, those are superfoods. And now I'm gonna talk about another really important superfood, which is organ meat. That's right, liver, which can be viewed as, for sure it's a superfood, but can be viewed as a multivitamin in and of itself. This provides a lot of the key nutrients that we need and can be used as your multivitamin. Now, most people don't like to eat it and cook it, but if you do, then you just need a small amount once or twice a week, 2 to 3 ounces. Cook it up, saute it like you would anything else with garlic, onions, make it taste very nice and tasty. But if you're like me and you can't have that much liver organ in your diet eating it, then again, Paleo Valley makes a wonderful organ complex that you can use as your multivitamin that you can incorporate into your daily regimen, and you won't even know that you're having the superfood. This superfood, when it comes to organ meats, actually provides key nutrients that our body needs, which is why it's a superfood and why it can be viewed as a multivitamin. Now, you don't want to overdo it, right? So if you're on a prenatal, and I often see when I work with couples that they're on a prenatal and they're on a multivitamin and they're taking all these extra vitamins, you do need to be careful and you need to manage that better. So I do suggest that you have a professional work with you to decide what all the key supplements you're going to take are going to be so you're not overdoing any one thing, but you could use this to replace a multivitamin if you wanted to as well. And again, all those links will be in the description below. I want to round out this conversation about nutrition by coming back to our digestive system. I have mentioned over and over and over again in this video and in many previous ones how important digestive function is. And I want to remind you all again and just take a moment to express that your digestive health is the key to your overall health, which is the key to your reproductive health. So if you're having any digestive issues, if you speculate you're having any digestive issues, if you have a history of digestive issues, even though they might be better now, then I encourage you to look deeper into that, to spend a little bit more time evaluating that so that you can understand what's really going on, address those issues, and support your overall health and fertility. I want to share a story with all of you about that exact same point. You all know that I work with couples from all over the world. Well, one of the women who I was working with came to me, had some failed cycles. She was, you know, upset and frustrated. And so she needed a different perspective. And when I evaluated her case, I knew there was a long history of digestive issues. And I had a conversation with her. I said, this is where we need to start. We need to start here so that we're setting yourself up for success moving forward. She was all on board, which is not always the case when I have this conversation, because many of you will always say, well, what does my digestion have to do with my fertility? And my answer is everything. But she was on board. And so what we did is we dove deeper, and we can do this if you decide to work with us. We ran a stool test. And in that stool test, we found out that she had candida and some unwanted bacteria. I actually can't remember which ones off the top of my head to tell you which ones they are, but she had those. And so I wrote out a plan to address those things. And so in 2 months, we got rid of most of those. There was one left that that was being a bit stubborn. And so she went on to address that, but that we modified the plan for her there. But already in 2 months, she was feeling better than she ever had in her life. Her cycles were starting to regulate. And when she ran her AMH levels, they had gone up from 0.3 to 0.95. That's a huge difference. And we didn't do anything specific for her her AMH levels and ovarian reserve. We just focus on her digestive health and her overall health. I just share this story because I want you all to understand the power of addressing the root issues and the power of addressing digestive function when it comes to your reproductive health. So don't think that that's not treating your fertility. It absolutely is. And that's where I believe all of you should start if you're having poor digestive health. So remember, as everything starts in the gut, the things that I had mentioned today, the bone broth, increasing vegetables, adding in liver into your diet and into your regimen, are all things that are going to support and give your body the key nutrients it needs, support proper digestive health and function, and help you restore hormone balance and your fertility. If you need help figuring that out for yourself and your partner, if you need support creating a customized plan for your specific needs based on your health and your history, then you can always reach out to me and my team to see if we can support you. If you want to apply to see if you qualify for one of my programs, then I encourage you to use the link in the description below to apply. All right, that's it for this week's Fertility TV episode. Hopefully you found it useful and helpful. And I did try to also give you some more practical resources to make that process easier for all of you as well. Again, all those resources are in the description below. I'd love to hear back from all of you. What did you find useful about this video? What are you gonna start to incorporate in your diet to start to make changes on your overall health and your gut health and your fertility? Comment below and let me know. If you're not already a subscriber to my YouTube channel, then I'd love to invite you to subscribe. Just hit that bell to subscribe and get notified when I put out a new video for all of you. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And until the next video, everyone, stay fertile.